वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द फिजिक्स लेक्चर। द स्टडी ऑफ फिजिक्स एट इंजीनियरिंग डिप्लोमा लेवल एम्स एट प्रोवाइडिंग नॉलेज ऑफ फंडामेंटल्स एंड बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स व्हिच हैव वाइड रेंज ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस इन द स्टडी एंड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग सब्जेक्ट्स। द इंजीनियर्स और टेक्नोलॉजिस्ट how to apply basic theories in physics studied by them in real life practical application. In these slides you can see the measurement in everyday life. A grocery shop owner will have clear idea of your requirement if you tell him that you want 1/2 kg of sugar. Suppose while taking the furniture in a shop, salesman, instead of telling him that you want a smaller table, if you tell him that you want a table of 1 meter length, 0.5 meter width and 0.75 meter height, your requirement will be very clear to him and you can buy the table of your required measurement. In these two pictures, you can see the measurement of length and measurement of temperature. So, these are some everyday life examples of measurement. In these examples, we use terms meter, kilogram, Celsius, which make the meaning very clear. What are these terms? These are units for measurement of length, mass and temperature respectively. The units so used must have the same value across the world and should be universally recognized and accepted. It is clear from this discussion that for the measurement of any physical quantity, there must be some well-defined standard. So, what is unit? The standard used for the measurement of any physical quantity is called unit of that physical quantity. A physical quantity. A physical property that can be measured and described by a number is called physical quantity. A physical quantity, examples are mass. Mass of a person is 65 kg. Length. Length of a table is 3 meter. Area. Area of a hall is 100 meter square. Temperature of a room is 300 Kelvin. The measurement of any physical quantity consists of two parts, magnitude and unit. Thus, when we say length of 3 meter, it means that the object has length 3 times the standard unit. There are two types of physical quantities. First is fundamental physical quantity and the second is derived physical quantity. The fundamental physical quantity, the physical quantity which does not depend on any other physical quantities for its measurement is called fundamental physical quantity. The units used to measure fundamental quantities are called fundamental units. The seven basic physical quantities are length, mass, time, temperature, electric current, luminous intensity, and amount of substance, which are independent of any other quantities for their measurements, are called fundamental quantities. And their units are called as fundamental units. Derived physical quantities. Physical quantities other than fundamental quantities which depend on one or more fundamental quantities for their measurements are called derived quantities. For example, force, density, speed, etc. Some examples of the derived physical quantities are given in this table. For example, area. The SI unit of area is square meter and the symbol is meter square, m square. Volume, density, velocity, acceleration, force, work, power, pressure, all these are derived physical quantities. As you know that units are classified into two groups, fundamental units and derived units. A set of fundamental and derived units is called a system of units. The physicist Gauss suggested to select any three physical quantities as fundamental quantities. Accordingly, many systems of units came into existence. Following are some examples of system of units used in which the base units of length, mass, and time were as shown in the slide. CGS means centimeter, gram, second system. MKS means meter, kilogram, second system. FPS means foot, pound, and second system. An ideal unit must satisfy some of the criteria which is shown in this slide. The unit should be invariable. Its magnitude should not change with time and place. Its magnitude should be the same at any time and at any place across the universe. Second, it must be easily reproducible so that its copies can be made. Third one, it should be easily available at any place. It must be easy to understand, and the unit should be universally acceptable. Use of different systems of units became a very inconvenient for exchanging scientific information between different parts of the world. So, System International Units, that is SI units, was accepted. This international system of units, called as SI units, consists of 7 fundamental units, 2 supplementary units, and a large number of derived units. The SI system has now replaced all other systems of units and has greatly simplified exchange of scientific data between different parts of the world. So, we can define the SI units. The system of units which is universally recognized and used by scientists and technologists is International System of Units. It is abbreviated as SI units. While writing full names of the units, the first letter should not be written in capital. So, as there are some rules for the SI units, the first rule is that while writing the full names of the units, the first letter should not be written in capital. See some examples. See, METRE, meter. The first letter is small letter and not the capital letter. Okay. The second example is kilogram. Third example is Newton. So, the correct way of writing and the wrong method is shown in this slide. Symbols should not be written in plural form. The second rule for the SI units is given in this slide. The rule says that symbols should not be written in plural form. For example, length of 20 meter should be written as 20 m and not as 20 ms. Second example, mass of 15 kilogram should be written as 15 kg and not as 15 kgs. The third rule says that only the symbols of units which are named after a person should be written in capital letter. For example, we should write symbol of Newton as capital N. We should write symbol of Joule as capital G. We should write symbol of meter as small m and not capital M. Full stop or punctuation mark should not be given after symbols of units. So, this is a rule for SI units. For example, we should write length of a table is 20 meter and not as 20
full stop. So it is a wrong symbol. Next example, we should write mass of a body as say 15 kg and not as 15 kgs full stop. This is a wrong symbol.